Do you ever find yourself in a situation you wouldn't expect yourself to be in? Hiding behind cover, waiting for the outcome of your decisions, waiting for the inevitable clash, waiting to see if you actually made a difference, questioning yourself whether you should have pulled that trigger or not. I wonder where she's now. I guess it doesn't matter, as long as the train got out of here, away from this corrupted town. It's funny. 2 days ago, I wouldn't have dreamed of being here. Well, people change. I guess it all started when the barber called a meeting. The clock's ticking. It's soon time to leave. My head hurts from yesterday's trouble. Damn migraine. It's almost every day now. Have to get these toxins out of my body. Too many of them poisoning me, making me sick. Need them though to get through the day. The memory of her is the only thing keeping me going. Even though I don't think Goldie would appreciate me being in this line of work. Or in this town for that matter. Cause around here there's a certain cycle. An order, if you will. In this town, everything comes down to one thing. Money. And money, well, it changes hands. But there's always one guy making a profit. The barber. The barber keeps control of the system and the town with an iron fist, making sure that no one crosses him. Or even worse, tries to make a fool out of him. There's always one guy who fucks up, making a mess. So what do? I clean. I'm the guy who does the barber's dirty work when no one else will. If it's a good job, well, I don't know, but it pays my bills. Right now I was about to meet him, but first I needed a cigarette.
Mr. Goodman, my friend, I'm so glad you could make it. Yeah, take a seat, right there. Would you like a drink, Mr. Goodman? Maybe a little sip-sip to go on the job, no? No. You're a sober man. I like that about you. It doesn't cloud your judgment, so you pop someone I don't ask you to, huh? Okay. Let's get down to business. I'm a businessman. I don't have all day, you know? Frankie, give him the envelope. The job is a girl. Her boyfriend, he made a stupid bet with a lot of money he borrowed from me. And then he comes back to me and says he can't pay me back. Make no mistake, I'm a reasonable man, as you know. Reasonable and good looking. But I'm not gifted with eternal respect. And when this fool comes in and disrespects me, what can I do? The next fool might disrespect me, and the next fool again. Where does that bring me? Nothing. So, I'm gonna get him killed. But this time, an example has to be made, no? That's why I brought you. That's why you're gonna smoke his girlfriend. And that's why maybe afterwards, we can get Fat Frankie to kill his dog. So, we have a full house, no? Like in poker, no? Not a man of jokes, I see. Really, it's just business, Mr. Goodman. You know that. I'm a family man. The pay is the usual. You get half now. And you get the rest when the job is done, capiche?
What's her name?
Why do you want to know about that? Alright. Listen up. I want the job done within 48 hours. Do you get this? Are we gonna have a problem?
You just worry about the money.
It's never the hard part to catch him. Maybe I should just have pulled that trigger. Now I needed a plan, or more likely, I needed guns. I needed Nigel H. McAllister. Nigel used to be a member of the IRA in the 90s. His specialty was sabotage. More precisely, he used to blow up stuff. I knew he could get me the guns I needed, and he was probably the only person that I could really count on.
You've got to be fucking kidding me. You come once again here, in broad daylight, telling me you want to kill the fucking man. That fucking man, you need a shitload of guns to do so. You expect me to deliver? Have you gone completely bonkers, mate?
No, for the first time of my life, I'm actually thinking clear.
Mate, why didn't you just do the job?
She was innocent.
Man, you've killed lots of innocent people before. How's this different?
It served no purpose.
Is it because it was a girl? Have you got the hots for this girl?
What's this?
She doesn't go with her. Where's the girl now?
I gave her the money I got from the bar and sent her on the first train out of here.
You gave her the mob's money? Now they're definitely going to come out here.
That's the point. Then it's always about the money. Now it's my job to make sure that they don't get her.
Man, you make it sound easier than this. If they get you, you're going to wish you pulled that fucking trigger.
But they can only kill me once.
There's another 5 minutes you've got yet. But okay, I'll get the weapons we need. But we can't leave anyone standing. If we leave anyone standing there, they're gonna come after us. Our only chance is the element of surprise. That place is a freaking fortress. I hope this girl's worth it.
My plan was clear. I wanted to kill the barber, and failure was not an option. Goldie, sweet Goldie, I guess that by saving her, I thought I would save you too. I tried to save you. I failed. But I will not fail this time. Not again. This girl is going to make it. It's funny. Even though I'm drinking, I don't feel the toxins in my body anymore. Nigel once asked me why I'm always wearing these sunglasses. I thought the answer was pretty clear. How could I possibly look anyone in the eye knowing that I'm a sinner, a disgrace to humanity? When I try to correct my past mistakes, my friends die in the process. I choose to believe that Nigel died for a good cause, but I was the one who was supposed to die. Well, I guess this is it. Have to get up. Can't fail her. Too much have already been sacrificed. This one's for you, Goldie.
Trouble, revenge like me, never sweet. You got yourself a